There's nothing in the plan that talks about eminent domain.
There's a lot in the plan that talks about that.
Playing to our strengths, which is the opposite.
Part, that's a good thing. So I plan to vote in favor of the plan. So with that, I'll take a motion to approve the plan. Mr. Flores, Marzan, you have a motion?
Chairman, make a motion to adopt the State of Rhode Island Draft Road Map, Rhode Island Economic Development Plan. Let's move into the future.
Motion's been made. Is there a second on the motion? Director Lewis seconds the motion to approve the plan. Is there any further discussion from the council at this time? Hearing none, I will call the roll.
And Rhode Island has just witnessed today the birth of Agenda 21.
Agenda 21 is the action plan to destroy your sovereignty, and that is your personal sovereignty and your national sovereignty. This is the green mask, the environmental mask, because if you are terrified that you're killing the planet, you will be willing to accept any restriction.
Hold on, you understand. We are not going to comply by rule. We will not comply. All right, it's called 1776.
This man's really an advocate.
No, I'm just doing my job.
Get you out of here.
With the press, you can say whatever you want.
How's it feel to bow down to Agenda 21 by the UN?
I'm sorry.
No comment.
No comment? You should wear a Nazi lapel next time you come into that hall. Because all you support a communist Nazi Agenda 21.
We don't trust the government. We're tired.
Well, here's one that just sold us out right here. Well, Mr. Comment, how you sold the
process? Oh, Ava. I tell you what, you're not representing all of the women out. You're not representing all of the voters in your area. Because I tell you what, when you get up and you say you represent the people in South Kingstown, you don't. Yet again, when the pensions of the old people, I'm 77, my brother is 73. When you go in and because of a puddle, HUD wants to come in a puddle or standing water for 40 days or a pond. They need that pond. You've got a lot to learn. And I tell you what, I'm going to be there to teach you.
My book, Behind the Green Mask, is a great way to educate yourself. You want to give this information to your legislators. Let them know about this if they don't know. And if they aren't willing to refuse to go along with the federal grants, with the plans, with the projects, then take them out. Remove them from office and do this locally.
Were you thinking the elf on a shelf was just a playful way to get your kids to behave in the days leading up to Christmas? Well, think again. According to a digital tech professor, you're actually conditioning your kids to accept the surveillance state. Think about it. He's always watching your kids. He reports back to a higher authority. He'll dole out goodies if they behave. And if not, their name goes on the no-fly or the naughty list. Are you teaching your kids that you're the boss or some unseen authority is the boss? In her recently published paper titled, Who's the Boss?, Laura Pinto says the idea of the doll reporting back to Santa each night sets up children for dangerous, uncritical acceptance of power structures. It teaches kids that it's okay to be spied on and you shouldn't have any expectation of privacy. Now, considering the fact that children have been told for years that Santa's making a list and checking it twice, Pinto's probably just being paranoid. But this kind of conditioning behavior isn't unique to the elf on the shelf. We've seen blatant conditioning like this in cartoons like Disney's Shutterbug Time. Camera-equipped ladybugs spy on kids and then report back to a central authority. This introduction to the new totalitarian society is benign, though, because the snooper is just a cute little ladybug who only spies because she loves you. This is, of course, predictive programming to get your children to accept the coming drone surveillance state, which we warned you about in 2007. DARPA researchers were working on injecting computer chips into moth pupa and then hatching them into sophisticated cyborg moths, literal shutterbugs. Now, if you aren't aware, predictive programming is a technique that's based on planting ideas and concepts in the brains of viewers so that they'll seem normal and more easily accepted when they actually happen. The Vigilant Citizen took an in-depth look at iconic 80s cartoon G.I. Joe and found a strange case of predictive programming. In the first G.I. Joe episode ever aired, titled Pyramid of Darkness, Cobra seeks to take control of the world by shutting down the power grid of the Northern Hemisphere. Other episode plots include the replacement of the U.S. dollar, confiscating citizens' gold, and the usage of mind control on civilians and MK Ultra in the entertainment business.
Cobra is real. You can call it whatever you want. Cobra is in control of America.
I am Supreme Cobra Commander. You call your petty bureaucrats, officials, and authorities, you will kneel before Cobra or face my wrath.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Well, that's it for our show tonight. Be sure to stop by PrisonPlanet.tv, where you can get a full year for $29.95. That is a great offer to share with your friends and family. Well, I'm Jakari Jackson from the InfoWars Command Center, and we'll see you again tomorrow night.
In the past decade, we have witnessed unparalleled scientific discoveries in the area of health. But no one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. DNA Force is one of the most expensive formulas to produce. Some of the ingredients in DNA Force are $12,000 a kilogram. We are using the coveted, patented, only American source of PQQ, CoQ10, and more. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? Well, we're bringing you a total win-win. The ultimate value, cutting-edge, trailblazing game changer that also supports the InfoWar. We have produced a limited run of DNA Force, and it will take up to 12 weeks to produce more once we sell out. Secure your DNA Force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. DNA Force from InfoWars Life.
You are watching the InfoWars Nightly News, which airs 7 p.m. Central at InfoWarsNews.com. Members can share their passcodes with up to 11 other people, and your support is helping us defend liberty worldwide.